Welcome to the next session. This is continuation of yesterday's session, that is learning objectives and hierarchy of cognitive levels. Now, before proceeding to the session, I'll take a minute to just share my experience about visualization. How can you use visualization effectively in the classroom? As madam mentioned, I used it for basically problem solving, showing one type of problem, making variations in the structure in such a way that students have to generate a second equations from that. So it took me around 15 minutes, but the experience is previously when we used to teach it using boards or maybe even PPTs, it was very difficult for students to understand what is happening exactly with the transforms. So after taking this strategy, after using this strategy, that is when I involved students in a prediction process, I felt that the understanding level of the student was very high and most of the class could easily write equations which otherwise difficult for students. So that is a small experience which I like to share. Similarly, tomorrow one of my colleagues is coming for the next session. She used this visualization extensively. She also will share her experience with visualization. So visualization will be effective if you plan your strategy appropriately. Now moving on to the today's session. So just recollecting yesterday's lesson, if you remember, these were my objectives: define learning objective, then explain need of learning objective, distinguish between appropriate and inappropriate learning objective, and write learning objectives in a given topic. So this is what were my learning objective for yesterday's class, and after going through the session, most of you, that is being a participant, most of you were able to do all these things. So this is the performance expected from you, and your answers indicated that you were able to do all these things, you are able to meet this learning objective. Now for this session, now you will able to list hierarchy of cognitive levels, and you will able to write learning objective at various cognitive level after going through this session. After when I'll teach through this session, you'll able to do this. So this is the outcome expected from this session. So now again, I'll just briefly refresh with the same topic, digital logic circuit being a simple topic. Most of the people may understand this, what is a digital logic circuits. This is just a refresher. It's an electronic device which is able to take some logical decisions. One example is given here, and such basic gates are there. So today's example also from the same topic. Now let us see the situation. One faculty member who is teaching a second year electronic circuit class, she wanted to teach basic gates. Now what she did is, she explained gates using truth table. Then further to elaborate how gate performs, what she did is she has drawn waveforms and explain how the waveform process through these logical decisions and how you achieve output waveforms. And then further, she tried to solve few problems based on the real life example and how to implement gates. Now, few of her learning objectives are as follows. Students will be able to write truth table for a basic gate. Then students will be able to draw output waveform when the gate combinations are given to the student. And they will able to draw logic diagram when a real life problem is given to the student. So these are three learning objectives was set up by this faculty. So now let us see, for each of this learning objective, there are different expected outcomes. Now what are they? Student will be able to write truth table of basic gates. So when they say that they will able to write truth table, they are just recalling truth table from the memory which is already taught by faculty member, and they will just reproduce in the exam or they will just reproduce in the notebook. Now moving ahead, look at the second one. Student will be able to draw output waveform for given gate combination. What this means? Now they have to first interpret the logic diagram, that is whatever is the gate combination given to them. Then they will find output for each block or each gate in an entire logic diagram. Then they will combine it, apply truth table, and then they will say that what is the final output. Now, here if you can see the first learning objective, they are just recalling whatever is taught to them. In the second learning objective, what is expected at the student level, more than recall. So here, little bit of thinking from the student point, little bit of integration from the student point is expected, more than recall. So they have to recall truth table, but they have to even implement it for a given diagram of the gates. Now let us move to the third learning objective. Now what this third learning objective says, student will be able to draw logic diagram for given real life problem. Now a real life problem is given to them. They have to identify how many inputs are there, then which logical decisions to be taken. They have to identify even gates, then decide what is the combination, and then they will able to draw logic diagram. So all these steps should be done by student, all this level of thinking should be done by student. So if we look at the previous ones again, the first one is they will are able to write only truth table. So students' effort are only at the recall level. Then they are now recalling truth table through this learning objective. They are recalling as well as they are trying to implement it too, or they are putting some effort interpreting the truth tables and trying to apply to the gate combination. Now if we move ahead to the third one, what is happening is here more than recall interpretation, they are trying to apply it to the different situations. So lot of things are going involved from student point of view or student thinking point of view. So how to assign such priority? So definitely if you look at this learning objectives, what we have seen, this falls at one level, this goes to little bit higher level, and the third one is definitely at more higher level because lot of thinking is involved from student's perspective. So now is there any theory to hierarchy or get a hierarchy of this or decide a priority of this learning objective? Yes, there is a priority list possible, and that is given by revised Bloom's taxonomy. This is the scientist, this is the psychologist who has actually given this structure of thinking behavior, that is what thinking behavior should be seen stepwise is mentioned by this Bloom's, and we refer it as revised Bloom's taxonomy, that is RBT. And this is the structure, that is it starts from recall and slowly the thinking level is increased and goes to the finally to create, that is the open design problem solving. So these are all levels, and today's class we will see how to write learning objective for all the six levels. So this is being a first level, this is simply recall level which just focuses on memorization and recall. So if you are listing something, if you are defining something, if you are stating the law, so there is nothing additional from students' point of view. They are just remembering the things and reproducing. So this is the first level. So to give you example, this is again a refresher. Again, I am using the same topic, that is basic logic gates, to write learning objectives. So this is at level 1, learning objective at level 1. What it says? Draw symbol of. So students will be able to draw. So students will be able to draw logic symbol of AND gate. Expected outcome is student already it is taught in the classroom what is the symbol of AND gate, and they will just reproduce it. So a simple learning objective here is student will able to draw a symbol of AND gate, that's all. So now what is the second level? Second level is the understand level. Now it is little bit higher than recall. What it means? It means that students should able to grasp meaning of the definition what is given, and they should able to apply that definition for a given situation or for given a problem. So action verbs which can be used are describe, explain, give example of, select example, so on and so forth. So this can, these are few action verbs which can be used at understand level. What is the meaning of understand? Grasp meaning, and then that meaning should be, they should able to explain that meaning in the context of given problem. So let us see what is the example of this. Now student will be able to write truth table for given combination of gate. Now all basic gates are taught to them, all truth tables are explained to them. So what they are doing, now gate combination is given, they will use truth table for all basic gates. They will integrate this truth table and then come up with the comprehensive truth table for given combination of gates. So this is what is the expected outcome of the learning object. See, yesterday we told you not to use understand as a verb. So here also this is not a verb, but this is the level. That understand is the name of the level. After recall, understand is the name of the level. So at this level you can use this type of action verbs. So when we use action verbs, we are not supposed to use understand as an action verb. Instead, this understand is actually label in blue. And for understand label, these are certain action verbs which you can use. So with this, now this is the activity time. Yesterday also you have done this activity. So what we will do here is, I will pose a multiple choice question. Then participants, you can discuss and decide one answer. Then you can vote for the answer, and that answers will be conveyed to us through a view poll. So now I am posing a question. Please read the question carefully. Now what is the question? Which is the appropriate level of learning objective for this lesson plan? So let us see what is the answer. So the first two learning objectives are at very basic level, that is a recall level. Because drawing of the logic symbol or writing a truth table for given basic gate, both the things are already taught in the classroom. They are just memorizing it and they can write it. So student effort is very less or negligible. While when the third learning objective is there, they are supposed to explain function of given combination of gates. That is, now they have to understand what are the basic gates, how they function, and then combine these gates and think how the output will be or how the entire combination will work. So the answer is this, the third learning objective is an appropriate learning objective. Now this is the activity for you. Yesterday also we did same activity. You will write learning objective for your course, pair up with the partner. Whatever course yesterday you have written, you can continue with the same course or same subject, maybe same topic also. And you have to write one learning objective at recall level and one learning objective at understand level. 5 minutes will be given to you, and then the same process, the RC coordinator will compile learning objectives and can share few learning objectives with us. I can read some of the learning objectives which I got from the chat. One at a recall level is write truth table of 4:1 multiplexer and explain the implementation of the variable Boolean expression using 4:1 marks. So this means that 4:1 marks is already taught in the classroom and students are just recalling it, and while explaining, now they have to do something more to implement this multiplexer using expressions. And one more I can see, that design a rectifier with specific voltage and efficiency when provided with one peculiar input. This is not at understand level. Here, in order to design a rectifier with a specific voltage, they need to invoke different formula. So if they are using formula, they have to just write a formula, it will go to recall level. And if they are using formula to calculate in given situation, it may go to understand level. But when they are designing, they are doing something more than that. So, this is little bit higher than understand level. Now, in a recall level, define radiation, definitely will go to recall level, and explain the difference between monopole and dipole antenna. So, using radiation pattern, they may define or distinguish between the two types of antennas. That can go to understand level. Construction and working of DC machines. So, student will able to explain construction and working of DC machines, will definitely go to understand level. So, these are the few things, few learning objectives I can read, and I think they are at the appropriate level. But if you try to write it more than understand, understand level is basically the formula is known to student, they are applying the formula in a known situation, or you have taught certain concepts, they are applying a concept in familiar situation, then you can say that it is at the understand level. Now coming back to the next two levels. The next level is a apply level. Since we have we know now recall and understand two levels, now the third level is the apply level. The apply level means the knowledge is used in a new situation. So what are the action verbs? Action verbs will be apply, calculate, solve, predict. So basically in apply level, they are not applying it in a known situation, familiar situation. Instead, they have learned some concept and they are trying to apply it to the available or in the new situation. So, it's definitely more than understand level. So, now let us see what is the example. Now, this is the example wherein a situation is given to them. This is the example wherein situation is given to them, and for a given situation, now what all they are supposed to do, students supposed to do? They have to decide what is the block diagram, what will be a truth table, how truth table will satisfy this given condition, and then they will realize it using gates. So, little bit decision making is also done by student here. Not only they are recollecting it from their memories, not only they are interpreting it, but they are trying to apply it in a different situation. Now, let us see what is the example. Now, example is this. Now, let us move to the next level, that is the analyze level. Now, there is very thin difference between these two levels. Analyze is, there is a big problem. Now, this big problem is split into the small problems, and then you will solve that small problem as well as you will connect them together. So, what action verbs we can use is analyze, infer, examine, dissect, ascertain. So, now let us see what is the example of this. Example of this level is implement BCD to binary decoder. Now, what it means? Now, first student need to translate this, that BCD to binary decoder, what is the function of it? Then, once they translate this situation, they will apply truth tables, they will decide what are the gates, they will try to minimize the function, and then they may come up with the final gate. So, here the different principles are used, different principles are connected together, and then it is implemented through hardware block. So, this is the analyze level. Now, again there is activity, same. Now, I think you are familiar with this activity. I will directly go to the question. Here you have to identify what is the level of this learning objective. Please read question carefully, pair up, decide a choice, and then when I will say vote, you can vote. Most of them you got correct answer, that is the, I will show you answer now. This is the answer. Now, why this is the answer? Because looking at the situation, basic gates and functions are taught in the classroom, and in a problem solving session, what is given is they. For a problem solving session, this is what is a learning objective. That is, they will able to draw and explain operation of multiplexer. Now, multiplexer is being a new situation for student. Only what is going on in multiplexer will be explained, and after that, student are going to apply, they will recall, they will understand, interpret, and then apply their knowledge in a new situation. But this doesn't go to analyze level. Why it is not an analyze level? Because concepts are not integrated here. Too many concepts, there is no various concepts which are integrated and done in the multiplexer. Multiplexer is just a new situation for student. So, this is at the apply level. So, now this is the activity for you. Same activity, you have to write learning objectives for apply level and analyze level in the same course what you have selected. You can stick to the same topic, but if it is introductory, you may not able to write at apply or analyze level, then you can select another topic as well for the same course. I like to share few of the learning objectives here, which may not fall to analyze level actually. Comparison between traditional and online transaction. Now, here I will like to give an example between what is apply and what is analyze level. If I take an example of a circuit, suppose we teach certain theorems to the student in order to find out current flowing through that particular circuit. So, there is a possibility that you taught them all the theorems. So, when you are teaching Thevenin's theorem, suppose there is a possibility that you will tell them to calculate current flowing through a given circuit. You taught them one independent source and you are trying to take answer for, or they will solve problem for dependent source. That is one of the possibility which goes to apply level. Now, when I want to convert this problem solving into analyze level, what I will do is in the entire circuit, I will try to give them a question which says that calculate power at a particular, in a particular resistance. So, what all things they have to do is they have to apply a Thevenin's theorem, they have to find out a current, then they have to apply some power calculations and then they will integrate it. So, that goes basically to analyze level. So, when you say that just comparison, in comparison I think it will just go to understand level than analyze level. There is one more this one, to draw and explain wall timing diagram of engine. Now, when you say to draw and explain wall timing diagram, it may go to apply level definitely, because here they are doing more than recall, they may be applying it in a different situation. Students will be able to select appropriate software model among various models for the development of software project. Now, in order to select an appropriate model, they may need to do some pros cons analysis wherein they are doing analysis, but this will definitely go to little bit higher level than analyze, because here decision making is very strong, they are selecting some appropriate model. So, analyze level, don't expect them to take stronger decisions. Herein still they are using content, integrating that content, and they are implementing the content. So, this type of student will be able to select appropriate software will go little bit to the higher level than analyze level. Student will be able to draw sequence and activity diagrams in software engineering. This, if it is in this new situation, then definitely it will be at apply level, but if they are just, it's already taught to them and they are recalling, then it may go to the recall level. So, what students are doing after you are teaching, after you are taking the class, depending upon that your level of learning objectives will be decided. Most of you are able to write few learning objective, and I feel there is very thin difference between actually apply and analyze level. But to summarize, I can say that apply means we are applying one concept, one principle in new situation, wherein in analyze case you need to integrate various different concepts in a new situation. So, moving ahead, so these are the last two levels. Fifth level we can say is a evaluate level, that is judge value based on criteria, and mainly as I told, strong decision making is involved here. So, assess contrast, conclude, evaluate. These are certain action verbs. Let us see what is the example. Now, there is a possibility that if there is one system given to you, one function given to you, it can be implemented using simple basic gates. It can be implemented using maybe a MSI device, maybe a decoder, or maybe higher level IC. Now, which is the best method? If you select one method, what are advantages of that method? What are pros? What are cons? All these things need to be analyzed, has to be done at this level. So, compare and contrast two methods for implementing given function. Now, please remember that there is always one question in our paper, that is distinguish between. When we say that distinguish between, it does not fall in this category, because here for comparing and contrast, students will select what is the performance criteria. So, the criteria decision is from the student side, as well as related to this criteria, what are pros and what are the cons of that method, that is also decided by students. So, you are preparing student for higher level when we keep this. So, when we say that we are writing learning objective at this level, these are all things are expected from student. They need to think of what is the criteria, they need to come up with the comparing and contrasting methods, pros, cons analysis, so on and so forth. And they should even able to justify why they have selected this criteria and which one is the best method, why it is the best method, so on and so forth. So, this is what we are trying to prepare student at little bit higher level, that is the higher level of Bloom. So, these are actually higher order thinking skills right from analyze onwards. Analyze, then this is evaluate, and the last level is a create. Now, create is the generating new ideas or products or new ways, that is you know one method, but is there any another method, new innovative method to solve same problem. So, if you try to prepare student for such things, then it is the last level of Bloom, that is the create level. So, what are the action verbs? Design, combine, devise, modify, plan. These are the action verbs. So, now mission or the learning objective for this, student will able to design a counter or a state machine for a given situation. So, what is done is they have given all idea, that is throughout the course you are teaching them basic gates, you are teaching them truth tables, then you slightly at the higher topics, higher level topics, what you will do is you will teach them how to integrate these gates and come up with few applications. Now, once they are familiar with the application, now what you are trying to do is you will give them a new situation, and now you will tell them that now look, it is already all foundation is done. Now, go ahead and design a system for a given situation. So, state machine or a counter is based on the application. It is not that design 6-bit counter, design 4-bit counter, that won't fall under this category. When you say a design a counter or a state machine means, suppose you give them a coin vending machine or coffee vending machine, and you will say that now design a system using gates, using decoders, using multiplexers to implement this system. So, when your target is this, that is you want to teach them open designs, then your learning objective will fall at this level. So, this is the highest level. Here you can see that the criteria is decided by student, then circuits are decided by student, evaluation is decided by student, and finally they will come up with certain product. So, this is what is the last level or the design level. Now, coming back to the activity, multiple choice question is posed to you, will be posed to you, and you will vote. So, here is the question. Read question carefully and vote. Now, let us analyze this. What is given here is, faculty is in the last session of the course and very enthusiastic plan is there. She thinks that I have taught everything. Now, let us see whether student can solve this complex problem. And she just describes what is traffic light controller, and now she wants that student should able to design this traffic light controller. So, but obvious that the learning objective should be at the design level, not at the evaluate level, because expected things are, student will be at the end of the session, student will be able to design traffic light controller using logic gates. So this should be the learning objective for a given session. Now coming to the activity, these are the last two levels of Bloom's. So now in a course, definitely it's not possible in all topics in a course, there may be few topics wherein you can write such learning objective, or it may be possible that even within your course there may not be scope to write these two learning objectives because it may be at the very basic level or introductory level. So if you want to write learning objective at this level, even at the basic topic, what can you write? So please try to write this learning objectives at evaluate, one at evaluate level and one at create level, and share with us. I'll read a few of them which may not go to evaluate level, but instead they can be at the understand level itself, like compare and contrast monopole antenna and dipole antenna. This may be like a distinguish between the two antennas. When we talk about evaluate, again I repeat, there is a criteria which is decided by students, performance criteria, and there is a possibility that the two methods, when they are compared, one method may not be always better than other. So this type of learning objective may simply go to, like compare and contrast may go simply go to the understand level. Now one example of a create, student will be able to create and design. So instead of create and design, you can just write student will be able to design high pass filter circuit for UPS. So they need to consider various inputs here, then they may need to consider what type of filters are suitable, and then they will select an appropriate filter, and then they will design a filter for UPS. If these are the goals, then design filter for UPS or high pass filter for UPS can be the learning objective. So when you write compare and contrast two things, again I repeat, there should be a criteria which should be decided by student. That is, it is not that it is already taught in the classroom and they are just mugging up the things and coming up with the criteria. So students' thinking level is expected here. It is not that whatever is taught they will recall it and then reproduce it. If it is so, it will be simply recall level. If you expect that in compare and contrast, then it is just a understand level or maybe even recall level. But when you keep a learning objective at evaluate level, whatever is taught to them, from that understanding, from that concept, they themselves will come up with the criteria and they will solve a problem. So this is what is expected at evaluate level, and that's why it is a higher order level or higher order thinking skill in Bloom's taxonomy. So to design and implement, okay, students will be able to design a windmill for enhanced performance. Maybe this will be the good learning objective for create level, because here now you are giving them a specific thing, that is enhanced performance. So they have to decide what is enhanced performance, then decide parameters, then come up with the parts of windmill, calculations are involved, lot of things are involved, and it is all done at a student's level. So if you look at Bloom's taxonomy, initially teacher support is there, and slowly slowly teacher is withdrawing the support and students are coming into picture, and they themselves are doing the things by their own. So the create level is actually all decisions, all performance measures, everything is done by students. So this is what is the Bloom's taxonomy, and we can write learning objective at various level, but it all depends on where we want our students to go. That is, in your course, what type of learning objectives you are expecting. First of all, whether that course is at an introductory level, or course is in between the two levels, or course is a higher level wherein you need to prepare student for some open-ended design. Accordingly, you have to decide level of learning objective. It is not necessary that all the levels may fit in one topic. It may be scattered all over the course, that is one thing. Secondly, there is a possibility that if you are teaching some introductory courses, you may not expect student to evaluate or design. You can expect student till analysis level, or you can even expect student till apply level also. So it all depends on what is the content in your course, what is the level, that is whether you are teaching at first year level, second year level, third year level or final year level. Depending upon that, you have to decide your learning objective. So I think with that, coming to the end of learning objectives, in order to summarize, there are, I'll just put this last slide of Bloom's, wherein these are the 6 levels. We start from recall level, we go to create level. Recall is the basic first level wherein you are doing lot of hand holding, you are teaching student, they are just recollecting and reproducing. Wherein the create level is a totally open-ended level, wherein you are now expecting students that they should integrate everything and come up with their own product. So this is what is we normally expect in a final year of the engineering, wherein they do project. They have to integrate everything and come up with an open-ended project or application-based project. So this is how you can set up different cognitive levels.
Okay, so today's session on learning objectives was a continuation of yesterday when you wrote one or two simple ones, and today you learned how to write it at different levels of the hierarchy. And the other important takeaway from the slide which is up here is that the higher levels are written in such a way that they subsume the lower levels. So Madhuri has spent a lot of time explaining that when we expect students to do design level or evaluate level, it means that we also expect them to know the definition and to be able to give examples and solve problems and so on. That's why often we put these higher level learning objectives and corresponding assessment questions towards, say, the latter half of the course or in the upper level courses and so on. So these learning objectives really form the backbone of all our teaching and learning, because when we have to decide what strategy to use in class or what exam questions to give, we have to come back to this. And as we discussed in the Q&A session yesterday, this is not different or separate from the syllabus. In fact, this is really together, you have to treat this together with the syllabus. The syllabus talks about the topics in isolation, and I mean, they talk only of the topics and the content. This one gives more information as to what depth we expect students to learn the topic, what depth they should expect to answer assessment questions, exam questions, and so on. So we'll continue this along with ET tools in a few more sessions. We'll learn about a technique called concept mapping and the corresponding technology tool. There are several tools also to create concept maps. And what we'll do is use the concept map tool to create a map of your entire course and see how the learning objectives fit at the different levels. So most of what you've written now are objectives at the topic level, say something that you'll use for one class or at most two classes. But for your entire course, for your entire 40-hour semester or year, there will be a few objectives, again of the order of 3 or 4 or 5, maybe 6. So how are the two connected and all? That's what we'll begin with in the next session. And tomorrow, we will look at how to write exam questions that directly address each of these objectives.